Hey, what is going on, guys? Ron here, and I am back with another video tutorial for you guys. Today we'll be covering this kind of indented or kind of this engraved layer style inside of Photoshop, and this can be used on shapes and text and things like that. Let me show you one example where I use this. You can see this kind of a banner that I created for a group known as Technobuzz, and you can see that over the center we have the same layer style, this engraved layer style, and yeah, you can use it for anything. And for this banner, I think I'll be covering the creation of this banner in my next video, so if you're interested in creating this, so do check out that for that as well. And but for now, we're going to cover this layer style. So first of all, let me create a new document. And sizing doesn't really matter actually, so I'll use 800 by 500 pixels, and I'll unlock the background and create a gradient real quick, and I'll go to the layer styles and add a gradient and kind of this darker black to a kind of a darker gray, and I'll set the style to be radial. I'll reverse the gradient and take the sizing up to 150%, and I'll take the angle to 0, and I'll hit OK. So really quickly, I created this gradient for the background because the main thing is the layer style that we're going to cover. So and yeah, let me show you. You can see these kind of ring pattern that appears when you create gradients. So to fix this, first of all, I'm going to flatten the image so that the color information is on the layer, not on the layer style. So to fix this, it's pretty simple. You have to go up to filter and say brush stroke and say spatter, and take the spray radius and the smoothness up to 25 and 15 and hit OK. And depending on the sizing of your document, it may not, the rings may not fade away completely. So to fix that, you can apply the spatter one or two times and the rings should be gone, and you should have a smooth gradient and the background is ready. So now let's return to our main tutorial and cover the layer style, the engraved layer style. I'll create a new layer, and with the shapes tool, you can use any shape really. I'm going to, let's say, use this default heart shape. I'll click and drag holding down shift to create the shape in a definite proportion, and I'll move it to the center. And actually, I created this earlier as well, so it automatically applied the layer style. So let me clear the layer styles and apply them again. I'll change the color to black. And let's start with layer styles. It's going to be pretty simple. And so first of all, I'm going to add a drop shadow, and as I'm going to use a drop shadow for the highlight, I'm going to change the color to white and set the blending mode to normal, and I'll take the distance off and take the distance to 1 pixel, and I'm going to change the size to 0, and you can see that it adds kind of a highlight over here on the corner of the shape, and over here and here, and it's pretty harsh. So I'll take the opacity down to, let's say, 9 over 10, something like that. You can see that it's a subtle kind of a highlight over here. You can see that in the original one here as well, we have this highlight over here, here, and you know, so we have the highlight ready. So now I'm going to add an outer glow. Color is going to be pure white, and I'll take the spread to, let's say, spread is going to be 0, and I'll take the sizing to 13 or 14 pixels, and I'll take the opacity down to 5 because it's pretty harsh, and I want a very subtle effect over there. So I'll change the opacity to 5, color is white, so I'll change the blending mode to normal, and I'll hit OK. Now I'm going to go for a color overlay, and I'll change the color to let's say this dark gray, and the hex code is OA or maybe 0A0A0A, you know, a darker shade of gray, very near to black. And the reason why I'm using this darker gray for the color overlay is because the background is a monochromatic background, only blacks and whites are there and shades of gray. So I'm going to use a darker shade of gray so that it looks, you know, for this indented or engraved layer style to work, the color overlay should be a darker shade of the background. So, or maybe not really, but for that I'm going to use this darker shade of gray. And now I'm going to add a inner shadow. Now I'll take the opacity all the way up to 100%, and color is black, and take the distance to 0 and choke to 18%, and I'll take the sizing up to 8, and looking pretty neat over there. I'll maybe change the color overlay and make it a little bit lighter. Yeah, this looks good. OF, and I'll hit OK. And I think that's pretty much it for the layer style. And basically the thing over here is that for the color overlay, the color should be a little bit darker than the color on the background so that this could look indented. Let me show you what I mean. I'll clear the layer styles on the shape, and I have one layer style save already. So this blue one, I'll apply the layer style on the heart shape, and with the color picker I'll pick this blue color and fill my background with this color. And really, to make this work, I'm going to go into the color overlay and take the brightness down from 35 to 30, and this should work great. You can see that for this layer style to work, the color on the color overlay should be a little bit darker than the one on the background, and it will look pretty neat. You can see that this blue one, this black one that we created right now, and pretty much any color we can use, and it should work fine. And you can use this trick, the layer style, to create indented text, shapes, and many other things. You can see this one, I created this kind of a engraved background for the text in this TechnoBuzz logo or the banner. So yeah, I hope the technique was helpful, and yeah, if you like the video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, and for more such tutorials, don't forget to subscribe to my channel, because I post Photoshop tutorials and 3ds Max tutorials on kind of a daily basis, not daily but weekly basis. So yeah, don't forget to subscribe, and if you have any questions, you can leave them below in the comment section. And yeah, thanks for watching, and bye bye.